So I'll call it to order.
Call meeting to order, Whately Board of Assessors, meeting on Tuesday, March 21st, 2023. First order of business is approved minutes from January 31st. Is that correct? January 31st, 2023.
Yes, approved.
Whatever. Motion approved?
Yes.
Second. Okay, all those in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Okay, approved.
Melanie will not be at the meeting today.
Okay.
I think we should jump ahead. I had some, you know, housekeeping things like signing motor vehicle.
Yeah, but we should
go right to
it. Yes.
And we should also find out what Angela would like to talk about. But we'll go to George Gay first.
George has been here a while.
So. Okay.
And I gave you a copy of the sheet.
Yeah. So what is the question? What is the...
Well, my question was why it went up so much from one quarter to another. It went from $1,314 to $1,659.
Well, of course, the tax rate.
I understand
that, yes.
I understand the assessment on the house went up, too.
It did.
Okay.
But it was last inspected in 2016. That's a while ago.
And that was only inspected. It was not. We have not been in it.
In it
since
1988.
So, if you want us to consider the assessment, we really have to come in.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, it has really nothing to do with the building. It has a lot to do with the land value. I think that's pretty excessive.
Yes, you're in at a it's in a commercial rate. I see that. Yeah.
But it can it be totally commercial without town? Because we're limited on what we put in there.
I am.
That's a zoning.
That's a zoning question, and I believe any business below a certain point on 5 and 10, when it crosses over 91, if it has a business on it, gets a commercial value. That's what I believe. Okay. Now, yeah, you're right. That is high.
I think it is. Well, my neighbor, which is Phil, Bob and Kim, I believe they have like the same acreage as we do. They're only in the 90,000.
Right. There's just obviously not in as commercial.
But he has a business on it. I mean, that's his livelihood.
I think we have to really look into that.
The zoning.
Okay. That's a zoning issue.
Because we just plug in what they tell us you are. And if they say commercial, that's the number that gets plugged.
You have our house listed at... Well, it was 209, but on a tax bill now it was 243.
The actual house is assessed for 172.8, and then you have 24,000 in yard items.
Yeah, a cabin.
A garage, a cabin, a sign, paving, two signs, and a freezer.
Okay.
So but that doesn't show up as a separate thing on the tax bill.
Okay, it, so the total of it would be 243,700. That's what's on the tax bill.
Yes, that's the building. Yep.
Honestly, I don't really have a problem with that. I mean, I know all the building. All the prices of everything have gone up, and believe me, the insurance for all the buildings have gone way up too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I just believe the land valuation is considerably high.
We'll look at it, I guess.
Well, I will call our consultant because it is a mixed use property. There's a house as well as
right. I mean, realistically, the business takes up probably a quarter of the property.
Yeah. So I will.
That's really my only complaint. I mean, I have no problem paying taxes. I've never complained about anything. Okay. I'm not really complaining. I think it's high.
Okay. It would be good if we could get in to actually see it, since it hasn't been looked at for,
yeah, what is that, that 35 would sort of years?
Okay. Years. I can try to make an appointment with my tenants.
It would be on a, well, it could be during the day. Are they around during the day? Would that be easier?
Well, they're low income.
Oh.
And then realistically, we don't even get what we should be getting. We could be for a whole house.
Yeah.
For rent. I mean, we're not killing them by the rent price at all. But that's why I'm concerned. I keep going, the taxes keep going up, and my rent is going to have to be going up for them too.
But I think we met them. We tried to go in, met them at the door, and they didn't want us to come
well,
in.
Well, it was 4 or 7 at night, too.
Hmm?
Well,
that's
yeah, it was late at night.
That's what we normally
that's our
make an exception to go when they were there.
Yeah. And they should have got noticed. Now, I don't know if it went to them or to you.
It went to us, and my wife said, you know, we didn't want them to disturb them enough right now to bother them. But if I can set up an appointment with them, okay, I can call your office.
During the day, we're around on Tuesdays and Wednesdays. And then once it's light enough at night, we go out on Tuesday evening.
Good.
Yeah. What time?
And also on
probably 6-ish.
On the property card here, it says exterior and the house. Okay, that's there. I'm sorry. The house was built not in 1970, but 1940.
That was an effective year build that was put on, and I don't know why the computer switches it over into the year build. I have 1924 for the house.
Okay, that's probably correct. I was guessing 1927. My father was guessing. And we've got from the exterior to the vinyl. We've taken the aluminum off.
That's what I have is vinyl.
Okay, see, on this it says aluminum.
That's an old one, yeah.
Yeah.
And according to the realtors, we only have 3 bedrooms in the house, not 4.
Okay, that really makes
bedrooms sense. Don't really bother.
Okay,
I can fix it and make it 3.
Okay, well, that's just questions I have.
The bathrooms, the kitchen, the things that are here.
Yeah. Well, believe me, the inside, not much has changed.
Yeah.
Not much has changed.
Well, we'll know that when we go in.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll see what I can do with talking to my wife and the tenants and see what they have to say about
it. And we're not there for long. Not like
5 minutes.
Yeah.
I understand that.
Yeah.
But in the morning, probably would be better.
Okay.
Okay. Let me see what I can do. But if you look into that land valuation, that's really my concern.
I will look into that.
Yeah.
Because that is a good question. And it's one that...
Especially when my neighbor is at 95.
Right.
And he's got the same amount of land.
That's
I mean,
the standard land value in town, basically.
I'm fine. Daniel.
Okay.
I did text you.
Yeah, okay, so I
really, yeah.
Let me see. I do have your phone number, right?
247.
Yeah, I do. I have it. Yeah. So you call us though. You talk to them and see what's a good time on a Tuesday or Wednesday. And you know, 9:30, 10 o'clock, if that works, 11 o'clock, whatever works.
I'm sure they'd like to pick up the house a little bit before people go.
People do like to, yes.
A little bit anyway, but okay. All right. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.
Enjoy the weather.
Yeah, you too.
Okay. Now we have.
Before we leave this, didn't we look at land values on State Road a year or two ago? Remember, I was asking why some values were.
I think we need to look at it again.
But I was asked why some are different values than others, even though it's all commercial. You had a table.
Well,
or something.
I think
you had something put together.
If
to show.
Just the residence on it, it is not.
It's not commercial.
As a commercial.
But this has both the resident and commercial.
This
so it's
just
commercial.
Use. Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
I need to look into that. We really need to look into that issue.
But if it's a vacant lot, So in the commercial zone.
We're
assessing it as commercial.
We have.
Because you got DeMile property, is that way? That's commercial.
I think we have it in this.
And we've got a value on there as commercial for commercial.
Yeah. But it doesn't make sense to put a house that's in a commercial zone. I mean, that was our thinking, I think.
Yeah.
It hasn't changed. This has probably been zoned commercial since before I began working. So we're talking about, the early 90s. Yeah.
Well, what did we do for the other property across from state across from 91 there in the corner? How did we do that one?
You've got to be a little bit more specific.
Okay, Monahans, how did we do that one? And zone commercial. We changed the zoning to commercial.
I believe that we have it in as commercial. I'll have to check. We write that down. Check Monahan.
Yeah.
Because that was something that was actually ruled on. And yeah, I think at that point, right, I changed it. Pretty right. Sure. Like 95% sure.
Okay. But it's the same situation.
It is exactly the same situation.
Yeah.
No, I don't think we can really change it. I don't think you can.
Change this one?
Yeah. Right. I don't think okay. So. But I will check. Because the one that always got me was AI. AI never had a commercial on that. It's not in a zoned commercial area.
Yeah. Okay.
So that's always bothered me. It's the inconsistency. Okay.
Okay.
Angela, are you still there?
Hi, I am still here. I didn't really have a specific question. I was just more interested in the process because I'm new to town. And I mean, my property value did jump by like 30% with the new assessment. So I was just interested in tuning in and seeing.
Uh-huh. And you say your property went up?
30%. I think so. I don't remember exactly what the old one was, but I think it went up by like nearly $100,000.
Did we come to visit? Because I don't remember.
Yes. Yes, you did.
Where are you?
What?
Weber Road.
Oh.
I can go. If you want to hang on, I can go and get the record card for that. We can look at it.
What's your number on River Road?
52.
52 Weber.
Yeah.
Want to go do that? Want to go get it?
No, she had Weber.
River Road.
River Road.
Oh, River Road.
No, Weber. W-E-B-E-R.
Oh, Weber. Okay.
Do you want me to go get the cards? Or we can do it.
I don't know if it's worth taking up everybody's time at this point. Are the old values available to people, or is it just kind of the new property cards?
Oh, you can always see older values.
Are they on the internet, or is it kind of a
community? No, I don't think it shows the previous.
So what is your concern?
That they went up 30% is your concern. What?
And yes, exactly. And like nothing really changed.
I'm going to go get it. There's just
we're talking about. Because we don't know.
That's
good, right. Off the top of your head, you certainly wouldn't know.
Did you were fairly new there, a new owner?
Yes, we just bought it last year.
And you bought it, was it from Gary Lawrence?
I think the last name was Saint Germain.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Trying to think of the property is. Is Paul Anteo your neighbor then?
Paul, yes. Paul and Maureen are my neighbors.
Right next to you, south of you.
Yep.
Okay.
You know the house?
Yes. Yes.
I don't remember. Ring a bell.
It's like a 70s colonial.
You set back from the road quite a distance.
Yep.
Garage on the left. You got some land in the back. How many acres are we talking?
2.5.
There first. Why are you looking at that one?
No. Oh, okay. I'm not, yeah, you have some land behind, I guess, some acreage.
Is that just the circular drive?
No.
It will be a minute because she has to find
it. Yeah, sure. It's no problem.
To the north of you is a wooded lot, right? It's wooded.
Yes. Yep.
And in the back, you get a view of the mountain range?
No, just woods and and sumac trees out there. There's like, you could probably see the top of the grad tower when there's no leaves.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, she's here. So wait a minute.
Okay, so here's the card. I'll give you the card to look at, but I'm going to see if I can find when we went to look at it. And that will take me a couple of minutes.
Well, we have it was measured and inspected 6/14/22.
Yep, so let me see if I can find it.
Okay. Place windows, solar panels. It's building almost
70,000.
Yes.
Well,
they're probably too tremendous.
No permits? That means
permits. Yeah, there was permits.
New ones?
22, yeah.
Oh, okay. So that makes a difference.
Well, it's room R/M remodel and solar panels, 3,000 and then a 19.
What is that first one? What is this 30? That couldn't have been. Oh, could be.
Remodel, 26 solar panels.
I don't like find it.
You did a room remodel?
No, we just put solar panels on.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
It looked like it said remodel.
Good challenge.
Good points.
Measuring inspected 19/22 for the sale.
Okay.
Yep.
We looked at it. We said it had been updated. It hadn't been looked at. Well, it hadn't been looked at fairly recently. That's what we did.
Kitchen back.
One from average to good.
Yeah. Okay.
Wait, what happened?
We looked at your place and we determined that the kitchen and baths were better than just average. We made them good. Last part of it. And when was the house built? 1973. We looked at it and decided it was upgraded. And so we added an effective year built.
So that's it.
And that's what accounts for the big jump in the value.
Did we change the grade?
No, when we change the grade.
Okay.
So that's what we did. I mean, it's our policy not to discuss things. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's sort of what we decide, and then we get back to the people who have asked the question.
I guess if you're still concerned about it, well, we can go out and look again.
We can do that.
We can go out and look again.
Do you think that that's a large jump?
It's a substantial jump.
Yeah, but
because I do.
It sold for this. You paid $440 for it, right?
Yes.
And values are not individually based on, but townwide based on an analysis of sales. So
right.
Sales like yours
have gone up.
Impact everybody in your neighborhood or with your style house.
So that's what we're running into. You're not the only person that it went up.
Right, sure. I understand that. It just seems like mine went up like a lot, and like the house north of us is a little bit bigger and on the same amount of land and is worth much, much less. You know?
I think you should have us come out and take another look at it.
Sure, yeah.
That's how we could resolve it and could speak to you face to face, you know, but
I mean, would just the, because the previous owners did redo the kitchen and the bathroom.
Yeah.
Would those going from fair to good account for, you know, $100,000?
Yes.
Oh, heavens, yes. They're doing a kitchen and a bath, really. That's what does it, is kitchen bath.
Yeah.
You change to, you know, ceramic tiles and hardwood floors and things like that. But that affects it much more than something like a bedroom or something. You know what I mean? It's because those are big selling points when you go to buy a house. I just think you should go and look at it.
Yeah,
she bought it in 22, I believe. In 22?
Yeah, about a year ago.
Yeah. And the thing is, with respect before in 2019, which was before all the rise in pricing and housing market went up. So I think
that. What is the date of the
We didn't change it much in 19 because there wasn't much done, I guess.
There wasn't much done in 19, so it stayed the same. In 22 is when it went up, but in between that time was, first off was COVID, and the housing prices went up, but also the kitchen and bath must have been done between 19 and 22.
It seems like it. That's what I'm guessing.
Yeah. So we went in 22, and that's when we raised it.
Right.
So we raised it in 22. So she's seeing it now.
Right.
Yes. You know, that went up in 20. You're seeing it now. It's sort of a year back. Yes, you know that.
Well, so yeah. I think the question is, do you want us to come look at it?
Yeah.
You know, how about if I'll contact you if that's, I mean, because you did just look at it. And I was thinking that seemed like a very large jump. But
yes. Well, like I said,
it's really based on the market, and the market pushed everything up.
Well, that and the conditions, I guess the conditions of the house changed too from 19 to 22. That's as much as the market. So,
yeah. No. And when we
were. What I remember, yeah, before that was lower value, yes.
Yeah.
I could say that.
Well, it's, you know, if we come, it's not like we stay long. We sort of, it only takes like 5 minutes, 10, 15 maybe. We just go in and we look at everything, and then we could sort of present that to you. And let you know.
Okay, do you just send a letter or something?
Yeah, Cynthia will send you a card.
Okay. That sounds good.
That's what we'll do. Then we can just clarify and make sure everything kosher.
Okay.
And whatever, you know.
Yeah. All right. Well, thank you for your time.
Okay. Thank you very much. What's next?
There are a couple of
motor vehicle things to be signed. There are a couple of these to be signed, sir. There are those for you. There are these for both of you to sign. Good question.
Board of Assessors.
Who worked on this?
I do, but they only give you two lines, but that's okay because there are only two assessors here today. So that works out. That's great. I don't know why they do that. That is very strange. That's what we're doing.
So how do we decide this last one? Are we going out or waiting for her to decide? Tell us.
I think we're sending her a card at some point.
Some point, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's just one, the front page?
Yeah, it's just that one thing there.
Oh, I signed it. Oh, I signed it on the first line. That's the greatest.
You think anybody looks at it who signed it?
This is good. Payroll. Okay.
I assume the image is still there. It's still there.
It's muted, so I don't know if you're still on.
Yeah, I'm still. Angela, are you still there?
Yeah, I am still here. Yep.
Oh, okay. Yeah, she wants to see, get a feel for us.
Yeah, maybe she wants to be an assessor.
Maybe she wants to grow up to be an assessor. They really find the ins and outs.
I bet.
Go for it.
Okay, so Andy Giannino, when he's just sold the home store, you know, where they're right along 91, the two model homes.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Oh,
okay. Well, we currently have it assessed for 563.3. We have not been in either of those model homes since, I believe it was 2008.
Huh.
Here. Yep. And it sold for $862.7.
See how much that went up?
$862.7.
And we had it assessed for $5.
$563. And we, as I say, have not been in since 2008. We've looked at it on the outside, but we haven't been in.
Okay, so we have to go in? Or it doesn't matter, it's been sold.
Yeah. So we'll see what happens.
When we go in and look at that, though, they're going to say, well, look how low the taxes were, and you're going to up it so much because it's so low.
They are in this commercial, thank God. Well, I just checked that.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
But what I remember, that house has no basement, no plumbing or anything, right? It's just a model. No kitchen. I don't know if there's kitchen. Kitchen or anything.
Is that the one that you and I went to only?
No.
Oh.
No, we went to the storage unit.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Well, for one thing, it really should be on two separate sheets. And we simply have a model house, and that's the smaller one that's the handicapped with the ramp. We just have it as a special feature for 93.8.
Okay.
It's possible that should be higher.
In the main house?
And then the main house we have in as a colonial. We have it having typical everything. We have it with fuel, gas, forced hot air, conditioned.
When were we in last?
2008.
Well, yeah, it's time to.
Okay. So, I mean, to me, this seems like a fairly reasonable assessment.
Yeah.
And obviously, it's not because it's sold for $300,000
a month. Yeah. I'll put it on your list to look at.
Yep.
Getting a very extensive list.
We are. It's this is not it because that's the old new girl. I thought I'd drop it in. Okay. Mustang that had bought the lot and the greenhouses across the road from Castaway.
Yeah.
Just sold it back to Full Bloom. Oh, now, I don't know whether Full Bloom, there must have been, I don't know what the arrangement was. I just think that they took back the papers on it. And my guess is they were holding at least half the mortgage.
But I don't really know. But anyway, it's no longer Mustang. I think they're California.
Right.
Okay. For cannabis.
Okay.
So that was interesting. And then you mentioned that you would like to meet later and not break up the day.
Can't we meet a little bit later than 3 o'clock?
Sure.
What would you like?
Well, this is just going to be like the select people.
It is.
What do I want?
We used to. We used to be at 6, right?
I think it was 6, yeah.
When we didn't go out, well, at one point it was at 7, I think.
Oh, 7's way too
late. That's too late. No, we have to meet. I mean, we'll start looking at houses, I guess, in about a month.
Yeah.
Once in a week.
Oh, we can go to 6. It's fine with me.
Or 5:30.
That's too early. I usually eat before I come here. So
6, I can do.
6.
It's just if Melanie was here voting, she'd vote for 5 or 5:30. Yeah.
Ask Bailey what times he want to eat. Or he doesn't stop probably, right?
Yeah, that's it. Whenever she wants, she just picks the time.
And then the other thing is that I will be away at least May 16th and 17th, 23rd and 24th. And if I have enough hours, I might even do like a day on either end of that.
Okay.
So what we need to decide is, because that's right in our, part of our peak goal look at house time.
Yeah.
Do you want me to set up the way I've done in the past when I've gone away, send out cards early and have cards all ready for you guys and you just come in and
that sounds fine with me.
It's a long ways off, but I figure. Yeah.
Are you away too?
No, but I would stay away from the 23rd, 24th. I think that's annual town meeting.
Okay,
so I could skip that week, I guess.
Yeah.
That week.
Okay. So you're sure that it's that week?
Yeah, I think they voted on it. Yeah, clear it with Laz Lynn or Amy, whatever. They should know for sure.
Okay. So skip inspection.
So it would just be the 16th.
16th would be the one time.
Yeah. And that wouldn't be a big deal.
Okay, so
you send them out the week before anyway. So
I'm going to send them out even earlier because I don't think, now some of the post office, like I sometimes can go into one post office and say, please, these are all for your post office and their PO boxes. Can you just put them in? And
do they do that?
They don't necessarily, they're not supposed to, but they do. So there it is. Now it's been public. So I'm going to send them out even earlier. That maybe I'll send out the entire summer all at once.
Go for it. I think that's a good idea.
The problem with that is, of course, then if it rains, it screws everything up.
Yeah.
But anyway.
But how will you know a week beforehand if it's going to rain anyway?
And I can't count on a week before.
Yeah.
And that's what I used to always do was a week before. You can't count on that. It takes at least 2 weeks now because it has to go to Kalamazoo and then it has to go to Timbuktu or
Boston and back.
So the whole weather concept, forget it. That doesn't matter.
We'll do what we have to do.
But limited to 4 or 5, I guess. I wouldn't go beyond that. I think last year we did.
You think trying to do 6 is too many?
Yeah, limit 4 or 5, even if they're the same street, whatever. Let's limit it.
Okay.
Get enough time to look.
I think we'll start with Pine Plains. We need to look at Pine Plains.
Yeah, I know.
And I've already printed out the cards that need it. And we might be able to do 6 there because it's even been blocking. But I'll look and see.
Yeah, and you have to take into consideration how many people
actually are
around.
Oh, yeah. That's why I usually have done 6 just as
Because people,
in case, otherwise you end up going to two places.
Yeah.
And that was really all I had on the agenda. Okay. Unless somebody else has any other new or old business.
I am all set.
Nope. So we should, I guess, adjourn the meeting and then go into an executive session from which we shall not return.
Okay.
That's right.
Motion go into executive session. Join
goodbye, Angela. We're going to bump you off.
Bye. Bye. Thank you for your help.
Okay.